And I ain't playing with these bitches. They childish. Yeah. Look around. They cry. Hello guys. Welcome here. Welcome back. Welcome. Thalia back in action. This is the very highly requested video. Lorelai, stop laughing. This was a very highly requested long hair, healthy hair, and my curly hair routine. We're just gonna begin with the gist of my background when it comes to my hair. Now, let me inform you how much of a psychopath my mom was when it came to me wanting to be a girl and doing my hair. Anything I wanted to do to my hair, my mom did not permit. I couldn't dye it. I couldn't cut it. I think the most my mom let me do with my hair was get some bangs. And now when you have an older sister, my sister is... I don't know how much older she is than me, but she's not that further up, and she could do anything she wanted to her hair. So I was a pretty upset child.
Go in your room. Go.
But now, you know, I'm not even mad at my mom anymore. I just want to say a personal thank you to you because, you know, you
held it
down.
Mom, I love you. P.O.P. All the day.
You did your thing. You did your thing. I was. So, yeah, you tell them. Say, that is not fair. Orla, you gotta let mommy record. Up until last year, I'm 19 years old. I'm gonna be 20 this year. Last year was the first time I ever dyed my hair. And when I dyed it, I did like high lift color, and I did like little highlights. I didn't do much to it because I was so scared. My mom made me like scared of any hair tool you can think of. The only thing I was a little OD on growing up was the straightener. I like burnt the shit out of my hair. Because that was the only thing I could do, I OD'd on it. I did it all the time. I couldn't stop doing it. I just love my hair straight. I had the curliest hair you can freaking think of. And not only was it so curly, it was so long. So it felt like I was carrying maybe like a 200-pound man on my head. My hair had been virgin up until last year. And that plays a big key role on why my hair is really healthy. Like, that is like the major thing. I've never done anything to my hair when it comes to dyeing it or... Okay, as for tips, we'll tell you to listen to me. I need all ears. Two of them. Open them up. Listen. This is the good stuff right here. This tip I am about to give you is going to be the golden key. You are in all doors when it comes to healthy hair, long hair, fuller hair. This is number uno. Skip, stop, cut it out. Stop washing your hair every day. Stop that. The main thing that your hair needs is natural oils. Not oils from a product you can buy from a retail store. Oils from your scalp. Your scalp produces oils just like your skin does. We have follicles and our cuticles in our hair, just like a pore. It's kind of like the same thing. Whenever you get natural oils on your skin, it's good. Excessive oil isn't good, and that's why you need a wash. But me personally, I do not wash my hair every day. I could even go like 3 days without washing my hair.
I am disgusted. You better talk to her before I do, because I'm hurt of feelings.
Ladies, do not be ashamed to go a day or two without washing your hair. Your hair will be long, your hair will be healthy, and your hair will be glowing. I'm telling you, this is one of the major keys. The more of your natural oil your hair has, and eliminate the artificial oils. Just listen to me on this. And thank me later. Like, when I tell you, this is something I live and die by. I do not wash my hair as much as a lot of people think I do. It's all about bouncing from style to style. Like my first 2 days, I'll have it down and I'll be like rocking it on the low. And then after that, it'll be in a braid, it'll be in a bun. I'm gonna camouflage it to the casket. Nobody will have an idea, but my hair will be healthy, my hair will be glowing, and my hair will be long.
You're being strangely cryptic as you wrap your magic hair around my injured hand.
Flower, clean and glow. Let your power shine.
Now, number two.
Cut them dead ends. Get trim. I know people are like, oh my god, I'm trying to grow out here. I can't cut my ends. I can't.
Well, mamita, if you don't cut your ends, if you don't get rid of that breakage and that damaged hair, it is not going to grow. And if it does grow, it is going to grow and break.
It's just like we can use an analogy and resort to plants. You know how when a plant is growing and you see like a dead leaf and you get your scissors and you cut that dead piece off? Why? Because the plant will focus on restoring that damaged leaf rather than focusing on the growth. And that is not the no go. So we need to cut that dead leaf off so we can grow and bloom. It's the same thing. This is another tip on the list that I personally struggle with myself. I'm gonna keep a G, but hot water on your hair is terrible. It is so rough on your hair. If you're realizing in the shower when you're rinsing your hair with hot water how much more of your hair falls out rather than when it's cold. Huge difference. Not only that, when you rinse with cold water, or not even cold water, cooler water than what you normally shower with, it seals your cuticle, which is going to give your hair more strength. Now whenever you go to brush your hair, they say it's not good to brush your hair with wet hair because it's more fragile. I personally take my time brushing my hair. I section my hair out when I brush it. I don't go through. Yes, baby. When I brush my hair, I will start from the bottom and work my way up to the root. Now, this sounds a little funny. Whenever you go to put a product in your hair, you use your hands, right? Now, however that product makes your hands feel is likely how it's making your scalp feel. And your scalp is just like skin. So, if it's making your hands feel sticky, if it's making your hands feel dry, not a good sign. We don't if it looks flaky on your hand, anything like that, pay attention to your skin. It's just the same thing. Now, you know, if your skin gets excessive oils, you could get like a pimple. Whatever the case might be, our scalp is the same way. So you don't want to clog up your pores in your hair, your follicles, and congest it with so much product. So less is always more, at least when it comes to me. And whenever I do use product in my hair, because I rarely ever do my hair, luckily kind of dries okay and presentable, that I don't always have to do it. But when I do use it, I try to use more with like the creams and the gentle things. I'm not really big on gels and mousses and things like that. Before bed, I try to make it a habit of mine to go ahead and brush my hair, because it gives your hair the option to distribute the natural oils all over your hair, your ends, everything. All of that is a major key. It's important. You gotta do it. Stop being lazy. Brush your hair. If I could do it with a baby, two babies, you could brush your hair before bed. Okay. Now, whenever I go to brush my hair too, I also exfoliate the scalp. Now, you guys are probably like, how do you exfoliate your scalp? So I section out my hair and I'll go in with like, this is a brush I use to detangle my hair. I have no idea what the name of it is, where it's from, doesn't say, but yeah, it doesn't say. So I'll section out my hair and I'll take the brush and go in circular motions and kind of just get in there. This is gonna give my hair the option to breathe, let out those oils, the good stuff. I know everybody's hair is different. These are just personal tips that work for me, and I am here to share them with you guys. I don't keep any beauty tips, beauty secrets to myself. These are things that work for me, and they possibly could work for you. So if you are having trouble growing your hair and you feel like it is not happening, like nothing you're doing is working, there are vitamins you can resort to that could possibly work. These are some that I did take in the past. Every now and then someone recommended me these. These are the hair, skin, and nails gummies with biotin. The bottle looks like this, and they're, you can kind of see them at the bottom. These ones are little gummies, and they're so good. You wouldn't even think they're vitamins. I'm not
big on pills. I can't. I suck with taking pills. I'm forced to take pills because of my prenatals, and
I also did take a few of these before I got pregnant as well. These are collagen vitamins with vitamin C. It's for your hair, skin, and nails as well, and your joints. Ooh, I almost dropped it there, but it looks like this. To proceed to the root and dive into our hair routine, some products I use, I'm just gonna go ahead and dive in. When I do my hair, I do my hair with wet hair. I do not like to do dry hair, damp hair, nothing like that. I know I told you guys before that I do divide my hair before detangling it, brushing it, whatever the case may be. But before I started the video, I did get out the shower, brush my hair thoroughly. So now I'm just gonna go ahead and go through and see if my hair has any knots. I'm just gonna spray this throughout my hair. I don't use too much. I don't go in specifically. I just kind of, and this stuff smells like if I could use an analogy as walking up to the gates of heaven. That fresh aroma. Yeah. Okay, now I am going to section out my hair. I'm gonna take this baby shark and divide my hair. Okay. Now, I'm gonna take this Paul Mitchell, the conditioner, leave-in conditioner, that looks like this. This stuff right here, I've been using this since I was a little girl. I remember my mom used to do like 50,000 moñitos across my head. She used this stuff and she would go in and like, oh my god, it gives me so much deja vu every time I use it since I've been a little girl. Oh my god, I love this stuff. Ooh, I almost fell over. Since I sectioned out my hair, it probably looks a little uneven in the back. But I have a lot of hair. So I take, let's say, like the size of a nickel. And I'm going to start from my ends to my roots and distribute this in my hair. Okay, next I'm going to take this Cantu with argan oil. Oh, leave-in conditioning repair cream. Daily moisturizes to protect from hair damage. Formulated for overheated, overstyled hair.
Oh, that was one of my...
My tips, no more heat. No more heat. Okay, okay. Okay, now I'm gonna go ahead and take some of this good stuff. Like this much, because this don't have a... You know, I used to not be too big on Cantu because I felt like it was a pretty heavy leave-in conditioner. But now I just been kind of leaning my way towards it. And I dig it. It's nice. Oh, whatever. So next, we are going to take our Diva Curl Archangel Gel Maximum Hold No Crunch Styles Define and Control. And y'all, tell me what this says right here. We just get in all the keys in this video. Same thing. This one I go in with a little bit of a penny size because, like I told you guys before, I'm not too big on the gels. I'm not too crazy about them. But, you know, switch to the other. Oh my god, que rico. Okay, bada boom, bada bing. Next section.
Mama.
What, baby?
Mama.
You want the baby shark? Okay, our last section. Okay, we're gonna repeat that same process to seal the deal. Now that my products are all evenly spread throughout my hair, I'm gonna go in with my Revlon diffuser that looks like this. And I'm basically going to get it all dry using medium heat and high power. So while I diffuse my hair, I go in with like a scrap t-shirt. And I avoid touching my hair with my hands at all costs because it causes my hair to be frizzy. So I resort to my t-shirt. Let's get started. Guys, now my hair is about almost dry. And I'm going to take that same blow dryer but remove the diffusing nozzle. And just kind of like fan it out throughout of my hair just to get those like damp or wet spots. Our hair is about 96.7% dry because I would be here all day if I kept trying to dry it, but this is where we're at. I'm gonna go ahead and style it. I'll be right back. I am back with the beautiful. Say hi. Guys, I am back with Orlai. I did style my hair. I normally do two piggies whenever I curl my hair just because I have so much hair and I hate when it is in my face. Orlai's a sleepy girl. Nothing new. But this is where we are with our hair. I hope you guys did like this. I was actually delaying on recording this video because of the fact that I haven't got my trim. And I wanted to record it when I had my trim, but people kept insisting they wanted to see it. So I was like, okay, let me get down. And this is it. Leave comments, like my video, click the little bell so you can get notifications when I post, subscribe, and share this with your friends. I love you guys. Thank you for tuning in.